comic 27. This one actually is the beginning of a new story because I can tell. Well, not just I can tell, but because it's the one after the guest comic. Because this is, if you can believe it, this was the entire reason for the comic. This one and this story starting just now. So, because I wanted... Basically, I tried to think of what I could write a comic about, and at the time, I watched a lot of movies, and kind of just... I mean, just described and talked about lots of movies, and described the different kinds of movies, and sort of made fun of them, so it was almost like a movie critic thing. So, what I wanted to do is turn this comic into more of a satirical movie critique, where I could talk... where I could just sort of make fun of different movie genres that I always found kind of silly. And I thought, well, how can you make fun of movies? And I said, well, maybe I'll make some ridiculous sci-fi thing where they get sucked into the movie, and then they play out roles within the movie. I seriously thought of this before ever getting around to this, because this is me kind of done with my basic characters. So I've created the characters. They work in a movie theater, which was the most basic... kind of obvious way of getting people involved in the movie industry. So they sit around the theater, they get pulled in, because it could just be that they go to a movie every now and then and do other things, but this just made sense. You work in a theater, you're around movie theaters all the time, so this can happen. So yeah, this was why this comic is called Intermission, even though there is no intermission in movies anymore, so it should have been called something else. Bad title. Okay, so let's just get into the title. So then Julie says, "Get away from me!" That's obviously just something Jeff would say. What is it? What is my talk bubbles? I always felt uncomfortable trying to figure out how to do talk bubbles. I wasn't sure that I should surround them. I didn't want to go all out and try to have to draw them in each time. So I just sort of tried to leave enough space. And when I left enough space, I then had to draw a big, long, ridiculous line leading to them every time. So, for example, in that first one, the one leading from Jeff's dialogue box is really long and really awkward. There's just, do you notice something weird with the screen? Now, if you look really closely, it's a spiral, kind of vortex-y thing, and that's what I went with. So I think she's starting to warm up to me. We're being pulled inside the movie. So Jeff, of course, being totally oblivious, still talking about Julie, obviously. Because he says Julie. I don't know why I said obviously. Still being kind of obsessed with being interested in her because she's, you know, a girl. We're being pulled inside the movie, so the screen itself becomes a vortex and then somehow sucks them up into the movie. This is the semi-science to it. Now, wait a minute. Pretty soon I'll be able to get her to remove the restraining order. And then I always kind of like that one. Shut up and notice the danger we're in. I think... that's sort of a zigzaggy pattern. So is that like TV static, or is this, like Well, no, because it would be losing the diagonal hold on it, because it's not the vertical or the horizontal. Yeah, so they're losing the diagonal hold on something that's a projection. So it has nothing to do with the projection. It's more to do with the screen themselves are sucking them in, but it would have to do with the projection because they get pulled into a particular movie and the screen itself. Anyway, I'm not going to worry about it. I'm going to stop saying they were basically. This is the theme, the crux, the point, the main plot of this comic. This is what happens. They get pulled into movies. They act out in movies, but they are kind of themselves. That's how it happens. And they have really tiny feet. Yeah, this is one of the first times I actually had to draw feet. Look at that, lower legs, things like that. They're all very tiny. This was a very faded back. It gave lots of opportunity to show them from far away. So giant heads, little tiny legs. Look, Jeff's head is as big as his lower body. The length of his leg is the height of his head. That's terrible. I can't draw. I just really can't. And the middle one sort of looks like an Eye of Sauron with spiral-shaped mascara. Yep, that's how I think. So, this is the beginning of the first storyline. The first storyline where this happens to them, where they get pulled inside the movie. The first time this ever happens, it's the first time, and there they are. So in the first panel there, that's them sitting in the seats, and you can... It's very... well, not very, but a little Mystery Science Theater. That's sort of the shot that you get there. I think in a couple of the earlier ones, there were two rows that I dropped, but I started getting lazy, so I didn't even bother with two rows and just made one. So that's one row of theater seats. And they are right there. So, yeah, so we'll move on to Comic 28 tomorrow. That was exciting.